chose to go on this journey, which, props to you, but big mistake.
The social game is the biggest aspect of the game of Survivor, and
I'm not gonna miss out on those first few hours of strategizing. It's so important. That's exactly how I'm gonna win the $1 million at the end of the day.
Mind.
I think she's got the perfect vibe.
Yes.
I think it's gonna be great. Us three stick together, we're good to go.
I said that when I start this game, the main thing that I want to do is immediately start looking for advantages and try to do it in the smartest way. It is hard in this new era of Survivor to look for these advantages and not get caught.
I need to go this way.
He's not by himself.
On day one, looking for an idol.
That could put a huge target on your back, but at the end of the day, I want to play this game as hard as possible. All of a sudden, I heard a twig snap. I look up and Asia's right there.
Hello, Mr. Gamer.
Huh?
I said, hello, Mr. Gamer.
Granted, I don't think she saw me pouring water on the driftwood, but she saw me looking really, really hard. The key to the box is at the bottom of the well. King. When I read that, my heart dropped.
I feel so bad I have to drink this.
It feels so, so difficult. You can almost feel like Jeff wants someone else to be able to know. He wants someone to catch me.
I got the key.
I got the key. I know that the key unlocks the box. I'm hoping that I can go open this box up.
Let's pry this key out.
I dug it up, and once I opened it,
it's way too dark.
It was pitch black. I felt the scroll and I felt the idol. Started really thinking, I don't think it's actually smart to keep it to myself. Maybe it's actually better if I let someone else know about it. That way they can trust me more. And Teeny, she's the vibe that I'm looking for in an alliance member. Someone that I can trust in this game 1,000,000%.
Is it like the idol, or is it
the optimistic word? Now I'm the idol fit for one tribal council.
Oh, so that's what
hey, guys.
Hey. Did you read this yet?
I haven't read this yet.
When I saw them at my box, I'm thinking, like, what are you doing? Like, 100%, I don't know if I can trust Teeny as much as I could yesterday. When I was finally able to read what was in this box with them, I was so disappointed. This box said, you can take it right now and it's good for one tribal council. Or you can take this other note, do another thing, and then your idol is good for three tribal councils. What about a normal idol?
I'm chill good for one, I ain't gonna lie.
I took the idol that's good for only one and I played it safe.
At the first tribal.
Yeah, that's why I was like.
Now they both know, guaranteed, Rome is not gonna be the first one gone from Lavo, and that is a great feeling.
I always knew, like, on the low, I could probably be a rapper if I really wanted to. It's been a couple years, couple stories, a couple smiles. Like, I forgot it in my head now.
I always wish that I taught myself all the Michael Jackson moves.
That, like. Be like that.
I want to do the On Fire podcast.
You want to be the one from our season?
Yeah. I could have done podcasting before and things like that.
I want to know the Survivor record for most fish caught in a day.
So you can beat it?
Yep. That's the sole purpose of that. Yeah, that's the only reason, just so I can beat him.
If you have a 6-foot Hawaiian sling, you have a 4-foot kill radius, essentially. You want to be that close to the fish, and then bam!
I kind of want to try it.
Oh, you want to try it?
Yeah.
So the current's really strong underwater. Like, you'll feel yourself moving away.
Okay.
You guys are down. Would you mind trying to start the fire that way?
With yeah.
All this stuff? Thank you.
You okay?
Yeah, just carrying this pot is going to be heavy.
I'll do it all, I guess.
I think I just have a different mindset. Like, if somebody was catching fish for me, like, bro, I'd be getting the pot ready. I'd be trying to make the fire. Like, what?
Yeah.
I think this is just ridiculous, man.
No flippers, no problem.
Oh! And I realized, hey, I'm kind of good with the Hawaiian sling. That's a great feeling because now I realize, man, I don't have to starve out here.
Pass it off.
But then I started to realize, okay, I had to make the fire, I had to clean the fish, I had to get the fish. So, like, at this point, how appreciative are you and why should I even give you some?
As much as possible. Like, this is all I'm gonna get from Rome. I know. This is all that he's willing to hand over.
Excuse you? You did absolutely nothing to deserve this. Absolutely nothing. You aren't even in my alliance, Asia. Why should I give you a big chunk of meat? So guess what I did? The last two fish, I ate them right next to Asia, right next to her, and I made sure I was smacking a little bit so she could hear it, so she could know. Listen, if you want some of this fish, you better put in some work, too.
You just spit that on my bag.
You also look like a
huh?
You also spit that on my bag.
My bad.
I was not a fan of TK at all. He was just being way too cocky, way too arrogant. So that was exactly what I wanted. I wanted him out the game first, but look, I'll take the second boot. In my tribe, it's Saul and Asia. They are running the show over there.
Like,
yeah, they're already driving.
Are you in conversations?
No, not one person has talked strategy with me this whole game.
Dang.
I want them to feel like I'm on the bottom and I don't have anyone that I'm working with over here. Is that true? May or may not be the case, but guess what? As long as they go back to their tribes and say that Saul and Asia are the ones running the show over here, that's all I need, because I need targets on Saul and Asia's backs.
Congratulations, you now have power in the game. This advantage allows you to steal a vote from another player at Tribal Council. This is exactly what I needed, baby. Now I have an idol, and I've got to steal a vote. Oh my gosh.
I don't know if I was really expecting to have this much power in the game this early, but hey, look, I told myself this is what I wanted to do, and I'm doing it, baby. That's how you do it on Survivor. I feel like I'm running this game right now. I feel like Survivor 47 is mine. We might as well rename it to Survivor Rome.
Ooh.
If I can make the last 20 days anything like these first six, you're looking at a Survivor winner right here, baby. No way in living heck that I'm telling Asia and Saul I got an advantage. I was lying my butt off to them, man. They have no idea. And right now, I feel like I'm playing it perfectly.
All right. So, anything new to actually say, or?
You think I would go out there and lose my vote? Come on.
Oh, my God. So what'd you do this time?
Steal a vote.
Get out.
Yep. So guaranteed, first tribal goes the way I want.
Who's going first?
I want to go first. Rome, please, can I go first?
I could literally jump off the boat. Like, I just don't want to be mad because I didn't.
It's okay.
Like, I'm letting you know I'm gonna be mad because I know I can do that well. So I'm gonna be mad if you mess it up. That's the only reason why.
Okay, that's fine. Rome, you got it. Okay.
The plan is actually gonna be Asia, but we want Saul to play his job in the dark.
Okay.
So,
I hear you.
Being in character and playing it like I don't have a vote, it comes natural, man. I can lie in Survivor all day long. I'm sorry, Mom. I know you're gonna be disappointed watching this right now, but I'm lying for my life in the game. I'm playing hard, man. If Boston Rob was the godfather, there's gotta be a godson somewhere, right?
Rome, every first... Why are you laughing?
I just was like hoping that you didn't pick me first, but it's okay. Let's do this, man. We here.
Is there a curse about getting the first question?
No, that's just Rome.
I got a superstition about sitting in the front and middle, and I'm sitting in the front and middle. So, I mean, I already got a lot of nerves.
Yeah, we're already 0 for 2.
Yeah, exactly.
You're not looking good.
Yeah, no, sir.
One second, Jeff. Went on a journey at an absolute perfect time, and you know, I was able to get an idol that's good for one tribal council, so I'm gonna use it now. But I don't think it's me tonight. I got faith in the people that I got faith in, and I'm just gonna ride with that.
First vote, Rome, does not count. Third person voted out of Survivor 47, Asia.
Tonight, tribal council went exactly how I wanted it to go. Asia went home, Saul messed up, and he knows he's on the bottom, and Rome ended up prevailing, baby.
Alliance, we still have the steal of votes.
Yeah.
Which, like, I mean, can guarantee Saul can't play a shot in the dark.
Oh, my God.
We can literally just tell him he's going home and, like, he can't do nothing about it.
Saul is looking hard for this idol. That is very scary. We want to make sure that no matter what, Saul cannot find this idol.
Definitely don't think this is the smartest thing to do for you.
So you're going to vote for me still looking for an idol?
If you're going to keep looking for one, that's more of a threat than someone just sitting back at camp trying to be kumbaya.
Everyone gets to look but me? Really, dude?
I'm going to keep looking.
I'm just saying, is it time to do it and is it time not to? And, like, the people at the top, they kind of have that freedom to do it. Right. But, like, I don't know why you would just increase the target on your back.
Hey, we're going looking for an idol, guys, if you guys want to come.
Not looking, Rome. I'm just going to refill my water. I am now going to go get coconut after this.
Can I have a minute alone, please?
No. It's a Survivor. I don't have to. I'm gonna follow you around.
Now, can I sit over there by the beach alone? Like,
I'm gonna sit right next to you. That's fine.
All right, whatever. Not it, Rome.
Why can I not get a piece to fit?
That is not the piece, Rome. That's not it?
That's not it.
Where Lava was struggling to get anything going on the puzzle.
That's not it, Rome.
Rome's plopped in front of the puzzle and has made no progress.
I put myself in the final position to do the puzzle. I definitely want to be the person that's in that clutch role.
Yeah, not getting one piece was demoralizing.
Yeah.
And honestly, I was just absolutely awful.
You're still a vote on him tonight?
I feel like I should at this point.
It's shot in the dark.
Do you think there's any way we could convince him to give up his shot in the dark? Be like, I am taking your vote if you don't vote with us.
Yeah.
And we can say that it's gonna be Genevieve.
Like, I could just straight up threaten him.
I'd have no problem doing that. I mean, you're gonna be scared. It sucks, but...
What?
Just wait. Just...
I feel like if I give him that ultimatum, I feel like he might actually break.
It's more than likely gonna be you tonight. But hear me out. I'm willing to work with you for this vote to make it the way that we want to. The way that we'll be able to do it is because I have a stealer vote.
Dude.
I will use this stealer vote on Genevieve tonight. But the only way that I'm doing that, and I'm letting you know that,
okay,
is if you give me a shot in the dark. I'm letting you know, if you don't give me a shot in the dark, I'm using the stealer vote on you tonight. And then you can't play your shot in the dark anyway. I'm letting you know that right now.
And you'll be going home.
I have the advantage.
What are you talking about, bro? You're like threatening me right now.
This isn't a threat. I'm just letting you know the situation.
Is this real life, bro?
This is Survivor, bro. This advantage allows you to steal a vote from another player at Tribal Council. Blah, 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 blah. And then here's the
can't
thing.
Give you my shot.
Here's the
dark,
thing.
Man. How can I?
That's fine. If you don't want to do it, that's fine. I'm using my steal a vote on you tonight, and you'll be going home.
I can't believe you're doing this to me, dog. You just threatened me.
That's not a threat. It's an ultimatum. Yeah, that's not a threat. That's an ultimatum.
Oh. Okay.
An ultimatum is not a threat.
Okay, my fault.
You're the plan tonight. I'm 100% serious.
Does Teeny know about this?
Everyone knows about it. Keyshawn is dangerous. All these brilliant plans are his. What do you want to do?
The second that I heard Keyshawn might want to put my name out there, I was a little bit hurt because I wanted to do everything that I could to make the alliance as strong as possible. And now at this point, I don't feel like I can trust anyone in this game but Genevieve.
Does Saul know about it?
Saul knows about it. Keyshawn told Saul.
My steal of vote could be massive tonight. Maybe we could just get out Keyshawn.
All right, it is. Time to vote.
So I gotta steal a vote, and I'm gonna be stealing Keyshawn's vote tonight.
Fourth person voted out of Survivor 47. Keyshawn, that's three. That's enough. Need to bring me a torch.
Guess what? It's time for the Aquamamba to come out and go out and catch fish. I did not think that I was gonna be a provider coming out here, but you see these people that you've been living with, you see how depleted they are. It makes me want to go out for my tribe, but it also makes me realize, wow, I'm doing something that I've always wanted to do on Survivor ever since I watched Ozzy just go out there and be such a free spirit.
Oh, I'm so grateful right now, bro.
I surprised myself, and I didn't know how good of a fisherman I'd be because I didn't expect it of myself, and like, it's something I had no idea was in me.
I put a lot of pressure on myself just in everyday life, because like my siblings are all like really successful in what they do, and it's like, so I put a lot of pressure on myself to be successful. And so like when I'm the one that chose not to go to college and chose to take the harder route, quote unquote,
I think the emotion right now is just coming from, I really don't ever tell myself that I'm proud of myself. I always look at something, even a major success, and I say, wow, I could have done this better, I could have done that better. Because I'm looking at my siblings and they're all great in what they try to do. My oldest brother, he works for the government. My next oldest brother works for the FBI. My oldest sister, she's a multi-million dollar real estate agent. And my next oldest sister is a best-selling author. So I didn't know if I was gonna be able to come out here and be great. The fact that it's happening, it's tears of joy. It's not tears of sadness. I'm super proud of myself. All of a sudden, I'm able to find this belief in myself that I don't think was even there before I came out on Survivor.
Teeny now has the opportunity to go talk with everybody. She's going to be a serious threat post-merge. And this is the other thing. Teeny did get a three-way amulet.
Genevieve has told me before that she doesn't want to work with you long-term, and she'd rather work with Teeny.
previously on Survivor. This Rome guy is playing really aggressive.
Can I have a minute alone?
No, it's Survivor. I don't have to. Really hard.
You just threatened me.
That's not a threat. That's an ultimatum.
And you best believe Rome's causing a whole lot of ruckus.
Such chaos.
I can't.
Last night, Kyle, me and him, while we're sitting there talking, he let way too many names fly out of his mouth.
Like, who are the biggest threats to Wimbledon?
Definitely Sam.
And Deanna with the dance.
I think she'd be fair. Piss off Sue and Caroline's right behind you.
But what do I do with that information?
He was pretty much like, in challenges, like Caroline is like super, super weak. And,
that's not true.
And he was saying y'all two are like a super tight dude.
Hey. People are coming for you. And if people feel like I'm the one bringing them that information, then I'm the one that they're gonna wanna keep around.
Well, thank you for letting me know.
I was talking with Kyle, and pretty much he was telling me the scarier thing in the game right now is Sam. Like to him specifically.
Really? Okay, well, for the ladies, who's the most threatening? Let me say to you.
What the?
The second that Kyle won individual immunity, I knew, okay, all the seeds I've been planting about Kyle, they gotta go out the window, and I gotta come up with a new plan. So guess who I want out the game?
I mean, there's only one person that's been, like, genuinely mean to me at different times in this game, and that's Saul.
Saul. So guess what I used? I used one little thing that Saul said during the challenge today.
Did you hear him when, like, we dropped the ball twice? Did you hear him yell at me? He tries to be encouraging and all this stuff, but he literally just makes me feel like such a little person. Because, like, I already have, like, self-esteem and, like, pride issues with like myself and like not being able to do things and like, you know, things like that. So when someone's like there not believing in me.
Shed a little crocodile tear here too, talking about my pride and how Saul's been demeaning me.
So it was rough. I didn't want to deal with it.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to play with people like this.
And as long as I can keep on playing on people's emotions, I feel like I'll at least be good to go for tonight. Tonight is about sending a message to Saul, letting him know that I won the war. It's all good. I'm gonna be feasting on Saul's bones tonight. Like, I'm running this game. This ain't even Magic versus Larry. This is Michael Jordan versus Kirk Heinrich, all right? This is not even a competition right now, all right? I'm playing this game on a whole nother level. I'm on Survivor, baby, and I'm leading a mastermind vote at a potential historic tribal council. It might be a Rome game or a home game, and Saul, I'm sorry, it might be a home game for you, buddy.
Maybe you should be sitting here.
If you want to trade for tonight.
Rome, come over and sit here.
Okay, Rome.
Tell the group, and I will listen, why the amulet advantage is not good.
All right, so we've got an amulet advantage out there right now. We know that three people have the amulet. They all went on a journey together. I don't want to be one of the two targets. Let me just go ahead and get rid of this thing right now. We'll use it together. That way we don't have a target on our back.
Duly noted.
Thank you. That was awesome being able to sit there. You know, like, I love hosting, I love commentating, and you literally have my dream job. So the fact that you even got to do that for 30 seconds right there, that meant the world to me, man. Seriously, I'm about to cry. Like, that was...
Really?
Yeah, seriously. Like, that was a lot. I appreciate it. Thank you, man.
Oh, man. I just don't want Saul on the jury because I know he'd never vote for me. Dude can't stand me. So, Saul, I know it's already going to be you tonight, so I'm going to shake things up a bit.
Rome. That's two votes Andy, one vote Sam, one vote Rome. Rome. We're tied. Two votes Andy. Rome. That's three votes Rome. Rome. That's four votes Rome. Rome. That's five votes Rome. Two votes Andy, one vote Sam. Sixth person voted out of Survivor 47. Rome. That's six. That's enough. Need to bring me a torch.
That hurts. Good game, you guys.
Sorry,
good game.
Good game.
Wow.
Just want to say thank you guys all for the experience. It was awesome getting to play with you all. Got to live out a dream. I got to sit in your seat. It's all love for all you guys. You guys don't got to worry about nothing.
Rome, the tribe has spoken. Time for you to go.
I get a hug.
Of course.
Appreciate it.
Nice having you out here. Appreciate it.
Thanks for letting me sit there.
You got it.
All right, you guys, all love, man. I appreciate you all.
Well, I got blindsided, and, you know, I should have seen it coming. But at the end of the day, that's my only regret. Didn't make the merge, but, I mean, I got to sit in Jeff's seat at a legendary tribal council. I played super hard. I might have ruffled a few feathers here and there, but hopefully I brought a little bit of entertainment.